There's a mathematical invention called the game of life, which reveals how simple laws can generate order and complexity. It's played on a board with counters, and the idea is not to win or lose, but to investigate the growth of strange patterns. The board is divided into squares, each of which is either empty or else occupied by a counter. There are just two simple rules, which are applied in turn to each position on the board. They depend on how many of the eight neighboring positions are occupied by counters. The first rule is the rule of death. If an existing counter has less than two neighbors or more than three neighbors, then it dies and is removed from the board. The second rule is the rule of birth. If an empty square has exactly three neighboring counters, then a new counter is born in that square. To play the game of life, you start with an empty board, and then you place a few counters down to create a basic starting pattern. Three counters is the simplest pattern to show any interesting behavior. As the rules are applied, it blinks back and forth forever, the central counter surviving because it always has two neighbors, and the end counters alternately dying and being born again. Now consider this simple pattern of five counters, which is known as a glider. The glider has the strange property of crawling across the board, returning to its original shape once every four moves. The glider begins to reveal the relevance of the game of life to science's account of the creation. It hints at the way simple rules and starting conditions can give rise to complex and coordinated behavior. This pattern of eight counters is known appropriately as a seed, and although the game of life is only an analogy with the real world, the strange evolution of this pattern shows a remarkable parallel with the life cycle of a flower.
All this has been analogy, and we've been talking around the creation. We haven't been approaching it head on. That will only be possible when we've got a mathematical theory. And when we've got that, and it's a mathematical theory based on whatever model we're using, it will be a testable theory because it will make predictions about the universe, and we shall be able to go out and look at the universe and see if they work. And I also think, and maybe this is the most important point of all, that when we've got a mathematical theory, we should be able to get some comprehension of what I regard as one of the deepest questions of all about the universe, which is why mathematics works, why it is that we can use mathematics to describe the behavior of the things around us. It's already possible to speculate on the form that will take, although I must emphasize that it is a speculation. I think we shall see that the processes that give the universe its stability, which enables it to persist long enough for us to come along and talk about it, will be very similar to the substructure of mathematics, the collection of very simple rules, just like we saw on the board, which, when they all run together, give rise to very complex, rich patterns. And the persistence of the universe will be very much like logical consistency.
Peter Atkins believes that what explains the universe is not God, but a simple set of logical, mathematical rules, which, rather like the game of life, can give rise to the complex universe we find ourselves in.
I find that very exciting, and I find the thought that mathematics might lie behind it all, and for there to be a resonance between mathematics and physical reality, emotionally and intellectually, very rewarding. And that's enough, I think. Of course, you can go on beyond that if you really wanted to, and you could call the logical consistency God, but that really would be the infinite emasculation of the previously omnipotent.
If science could show how the universe started all by itself, would John Polkinghorne's faith be shaken?
I don't think it would. I mean, the inflationary story is essentially saying that certain peculiar features of the initial conditions of the universe are in fact understandable in terms of the structure of the laws. There is always a balance between the laws of physics and the initial conditions that you put in. And the inflationary idea, as I understand it, shift that balance to say that the rather special initial conditions are rather likely to arise from theories of a particular closely knit structure. It's still a very remarkable fact about the world that the laws of physics can have such non-trivial consequences, that there is this potentiality built into them, that out of chaos they can lead in a smooth evolution to the creation of order, to the creation of people like you and me. That's a remarkable and striking fact about the world. And if I think of the laws of physics as being reflections of the will of the Creator, they show me the creative process at work. I don't think God is more to be found in initial conditions than in continuing laws.
But some scientists accept the laws of physics as ultimate truths. Why then does John Polkinghorne feel inclined to seek beyond them?
I think one would possibly ask the question of why are we able to discern the laws of physics? Why do they have such a beautiful structure? You can, of course, deny yourself the right to ask that question, but it seems to me a very natural question to ask. And there are many other natural questions that I want to ask about the world. Why is it a world that contains the experience of beauty? Why is it a world that contains the experience of moral obligation? Why is it a world that contains the experience of worship and the presence of another? And it's in looking for a total explanation of the world in that sort of way that I want to look for a God, a creator God, as the foundation explanation of those things.
Our world, it seems, is a still mysterious pattern woven by the simple laws of physics. As author and sustainer of these laws, God is certainly one explanation of the universe. But what does science have to say about where the laws of physics come from?
One of the amazing things about physics, which is really what makes it so exciting for me, is that the laws of physics seem to turn out to be astonishingly more simple than you would have expected. If you look around the world that we observe, sunrises, trees, people, you see an enormous complexity of phenomena. And I think it's amazing that when these phenomena are studied more and more closely, what we seem to find is that they're in fact dictated by a very simple set of rules. And the further we delve into the study of these rules, the simpler they appear. Now, I don't think we know the reason why this is the case, but it is certainly astonishing, and it would be very nice if someday we did understand the reason for it.